Hi friends, welcome all of you back to my YouTube channel. This is Voltage.amp1. In this tutorial, I am going to talk about the process of installing a virtual system inside of Android 12. As you already know, there are so many virtual systems that really support root and exposit and release it for Android. But most of these virtual systems doesn't really support for Android 12 because the developers still doesn't update their virtual systems for Android 12. That's why we are getting black screen and post-close issues on the opening process of those virtual systems on our Android 12 device. So in this tutorial, I'm going to publish the three virtual systems that really support and available to Android 12 and the process of installing and setting up them on our Android devices. So let's start our video and see how we can do this. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, turn on notification net and join with me. Okay friends, these are the three new virtual systems that really support for Android 12, Vmos Pro, X8 SandBox and F1VM. So if you are going to install F1VM application or X8 SandBox application on your Android 12 device, you need to install X8 and F1 launcher application also. And also if you are going to install the Vmos application, you need to install Vmos assistant also. So I have already put these download links into the description of this video. You can refer to that link to download them. So let's continue and see how we can install these applications one by one on our Android 12 device. Okay guys, firstly I'm going to install X8 SandBox application. You need to install these two applications on your Android device, X8 SandBox application and also the X8 F1 launcher application. Firstly, you need to launch this F1 and X8 launcher application. Then click on allow to this message and click on repair. Now you need to connect to a Wi-Fi network. So I am using my Android device to turn on hotspot. Now you can see I have connected to Wi-Fi network. Then you need to allow notification setting for this application. Now you need to enable your developer settings. Go to your setting application like this. Click on the about phone option and you need to tap on your build number until you are getting this screen to enter your password. Then enter your password and then your developer mode will be enabled. Now click on back button and click on again back. Now you can come to this screen, then you need to enable the developer options. You can see it's already enabled. If doesn't, you can enable it. Now scroll down and you need to find wireless debugging option. Now enable it. Then click on allow icon and click on allow again. Now click on to pair option. Then scroll down and go to wireless debugging option again. Then click on here. Then you can get this code. Now you can see this notification which comes from X8 SandBox launcher application. Now click on this arrow icon. Now you need to click on here to enter your pairing code. Now click on this icon. Now you have setting up everything on this X8 SandBox and F1VM launcher. Now you can launch your X8 SandBox application normally. Click on agree and allow to the all permissions and setting up this application for your device. Now you can see we have successfully setting up X8 SandBox application on our Android 12. So let's see how we can setting up this F1VM application also on our devices. So guys, once you have successfully setting up this X8 SandBox and F1 launcher application on your device, you don't need to setting up this one. Use X8 SandBox or F1VM once again. So you can launch your F1VM application as normally to run and install it on your device. you can see here I'm going to launch my F1VM application. It's starting normally. We don't need to do anything here. Click on agree and complete this small startup process. So guys, when it comes to here, you can see we have successfully setting up this F1VM application also on our Android 12 devices. So you can see here, once we have successfully setting up this X8 and F1 launcher application on our devices, we can launch this X8 sandbox application and F1VM application also on our Android 12 devices. So with this, I'm moving to talk about the installation and setting up process of Vmos Pro application. Okay friends, firstly you need to download and install this Vmos Pro and Vmos Assistant applications on your device. Firstly, you need to launch Vmos Assistant application. Before launching of the Vmos Pro application, then click here and click on this blue area. Again, you need to click on this blue area, then click on allow option. Now again click here, then click on this option. Now you need to connect to a Wi-Fi network. Now I'm going to connect to the Wi-Fi network of my next phone from opening the hotspot access. Now click on this second option, then scroll down and go to about phone option and tap on your build number until you get this your developer mode enabled notification. Then press back button again and go to third option. Now you need to enable wireless debugging option. Now press back button again and you need to go to this last option. Now again you need to find your wireless debugging option and click on it. Then you need to click on this pair device with the pair encode option. Then you need to open your notification bar. If you have enabled this do not disturb option, your notification will not be appeared. So you need to close it. Then your all notification will be appeared like this. Click on this arrow icon and click on here to enter your pair encode. Now click on here. Now you have successfully setting up Vmos Assistant application to work with Vmos Pro. Then we can normally launch our Vmos Pro application. Now you need to go to these processes and complete them one by one. Now click on this plus button to add a virtual machine. I'm going to recover my old virtual machine that I have already backed up. If you wish to add a new virtual system, you can download them like this. Now click on here to recover your previous virtual machine. If you have already backed up virtual machine, I'm going to recover this one. When it comes to here, you need to select the applications that you want to install on inside of this virtual system. Now you can see we have successfully setting up everything on this virtual machine. So when it comes to here, you can see we have successfully installed our virtual system without having any errors. So this is the process that you can install any virtual system on Android 12 if those are supported and released for Android 12. So with this, I'm going to wind up this video. Thank you all for watching this tutorial. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, turn on notification net and join with me.